Everybody, welcome back to my channel. It's Jenny here from So Busy Drawing. I hope everybody's been keeping well. It's been a long time putting any videos out, so I thought I'd do one today. The video I'm doing today is these show you how I make these little slow stitched hearts. You can see a little video of these on my shorts, but I thought it'd be quite nice to show how I make them. So I've done them in just the one colour. And they're all hand stitched and they're all made using recycled fabrics, like the little tiny bits that you don't, that you might think about throwing away. Done one blue, one yellow, again, one in a purple, various stitches, added sequins and beads, etc. On here, I've got a little butterfly as well. I've added that on there. On this one, a bit of a necklace as well that I've added on there. Again, loads of different stitches. You can do them in different colours, you can do them in one colour, it's entirely up to you. And then this one, a little bit different, it made a little sunshine face on this one, which I thought I'd have a go at trying something a little bit different on these hearts. And it's just, you know, they're like the leftover fabrics, and then the back end is plain on that one. And on this one, I did put a bit of lace, because you could tuck something in there. If you stitched that along there, you could tuck like a little note or something in there, or a little gift, and then they can have that as a little surprise there. But yeah, so these are ideal to give as gifts. You can put them in cards. I made these and I hung them on my tree last year, so yeah, and you can make a little group of them like that, and you can have them as little heart bunting if you wanted to. But yeah, there's loads of ideas and things you can do with them. And that's another one there again. Lift that up and then you just see the bit of heart underneath and stitches there. So all you need for this little project, a little heart template that I've cut out of paper. So all I've done is drawn half a heart, shall we say. I don't know if that pen's working, just choose this. So just some folded paper, a bit of scrap paper there. And to get the heart template, you just draw a heart shape like that. And you can make these as big or as small as you like. And then we just cut around that. And that's your heart template, like so. You just round it off, like neaten up. Like I said, cut them as big or as small as you like. So I've cut one out earlier. And then in the centre, I've just got a little bit of felt. So I'm just going to draw around that and cut that out. That way, actually, yeah. And then for this one, I've just got some little bits of orange material. I thought I'd make a little orange one, a bit of yellow thrown in as well. So all I've got a bit of orange here. And then what I do, I just cover it over. And then what I've also, what I've realised, if you want to show your stitches off, I tend to use like plain fabrics, but then mix it in with a little bit of decorative fabric as well, like this little check. And I'm going to just see, I've got a bit of yellow here. I'm going to throw a bit of yellow in. Yeah, I think I'll throw a bit of yellow in. And then you just sort of, you know, play around with your fabrics and get them how you like them to be. I've got a bracelet on, I'll just take that off for a minute. That's that there. So I can move this over a little bit. It's a bit of a gap. That's better. See if that covers that bit there. That bit should cover that bit there. And then, let me just see if I've got another little bit of a different orange I can add on that. Just a little bit of this. I think this is similar. Yeah, it's a bit similar, that one, isn't it? Right, I've got a bit of this. I think I'll put a bit of this on. Just to stop a little bit of it's a bit of wool, isn't it? Like, yeah, so just pop that on. Place on there. And then, so once I've got my fabrics down, my little piece of materials, I just do a running stitch to keep them all in place. I can pin your pieces down, I'll just tend to so we'll have to start here. I can just sort of feel where the edge of the heart is underneath my finger as I'm putting my needle through, so that's giving me. So I'm guiding myself as I go around, guiding where the stitches go. On the back, do one more down there. Bring my camera over this way a bit, just because I'm conscious that I keep bringing my sewing closer to me and you can't see what I'm doing. I just Now, if you wanted to, you could go around and do a little basting stitch, which is basically like a little running stitch all the way around, but with just a bit of cotton. But I'm going straight in. Now you can see that I've got a gap there, but on these, I don't worry about the little gaps if they're not reaching, because they will be embellished. So I can move that over like that, you see, and it could go like that. So then what I do now is put a knot in there and then just trim off the excess material. Just leave that a little bit. Got a bit of orange lace here, which I've taken off another project. So what I do just cut some of them flowers out. Big one on there, actually. So I'm going to try and make that a bit smaller so it dominates the whole of the heart. Okay, there. We'll come back to that actually. So smaller one there actually. I could just slide that under there, that's better. Right, so now I'll start doing some little stitches. Again, I've just got my orange thread. I think we just do a little stitch on this one. And I've got different type of got corally colour here, which is quite nice. Just some of that. See, I've got a little orange bit in here. That's nice. There's some mint. Yep, there's some orange bit in there. Pop a button on. They don't take long to make as well. I mean, these are smaller ones, but I'll texture that. So around here I'm just going to do like little seed stitch, and then I'm going to go over a little lace flower with seed stitch. I've got a little nick in the fabric there, so what I'm going to do is just see if I've got something little I can put in there. Let's have a look what else. Let's see if we can get a different colour. Actually, a bit of yellow. Nice. With a yellow and orange heart. Excuse me. see if I've got a little. Oh, I fancy in this. I don't know. Right, so a bit more texture. Must be some type of wool or something. I don't know. I'm going to couch this down, this little bit here. Sorry, I can't really come knock at my camera. You can stitch little words on as well if you like. So just another little idea. All right, I think what we need is some little beads. I'm just going to go through these ones. I want to get a different. Oh no, it's gone through. Tiny seed beads, these are. Quite nice to make. Well, I'm just thinking of making one, like thinking of you. So, you know, you could make one of these and then just, you know, stitch the words on. That'd be a nice little idea. And obviously, using the bright colours, just upliftment and positivity. So, stitch a few beads on there. Now what I might do, I'm going to just put in some French knots. Just give it more texture. See if I can right, let me see what we've got here. So what I've got here is a massive box of everything, like loads and loads of sequins I've had for years. So I've just got them all in a tray. That was part of an earring there. Look, that's quite nice, isn't it? Look. So you can put anything on them. That's really nice, actually. I'll put that on there. I'll see if this will work. Right, a bit of orange thread. It was part of an earring or a necklace, I'm not sure. I've just stitched it on. That's nice, that is. I'll put another one there. could put some under here actually. No, it's a bit flat. Have a look. Beads. So LO, look. Got a lip on them. I'll come back to that. So there you go, so that's what I've done so far. So I've done stitching here with some French knots and beads, a little bit of lace, a button, either an earring or part of an earring or a necklace, and then some wool as well, which I've used, which I've just couched, and then this little bit of wool here as well. Let's see. Just see if I've got a bit of orange. Oh, I've got some now, haven't I? Use a little bit of this just to go in there. It's constantly having a little play. Look at that, I've double threaded the needle. Look at that, two needles on here. Two in here. Let's put some a bit of cross stitch on here, I think. A bit of orange. Whoops. Oh, a little orange rose under there. Actually, put that one there. think I'm going to do a satin cross stitch actually. Quite like that one there. Just getting a different needle, struggling to thread them ones, isn't it? They're too small. So, I mean, this is just an idea, but like I say, you can, you know, decorate them however you wish, but they're so lovely to make, and it's a nice little easy project. You know, you can use over your bits of fabrics. You know, do a bit of, do your stitches, and then just decorate. I mean, if you wanted to, is also depending on if you were gifting, you could also put herbs in. And I've got some lavender downstairs, so I could put lavender in it. But obviously, if you were to gift it, you know, just make sure you tell them the make sure you know that person likes lavender or whatever herb they like. Rose may be quite nice as well. Now, what I'll probably do is I will probably go in and add a few more little gold bits, I think, just to make it pop a little bit more. But I'll go back to that. But just to show you how I do the backing. So this bit of fabric again. And then you can use your template to cut the backing. Put your heart down and then just draw around it. Actually, by doing this, you give yourself a little bit of extra material for the backing as well. Then we'll just cut that out. Again, if you need to, you can trim it down to size, it's fine. So that sits on there like that, and then I also add a little bit of ribbon if you wish to hang it. So let me see what I've got in here. Don't think I've got any orange or yellow ribbon, I don't think. What's this? Oh. Let's have a look. You could use a little bit of wool, a little bit of string if you like. Oh yeah, I've got some. I'll use this actually. Is this not big enough? It's a bit thick. I'm looking at some wool I have, but it's a bit too thick. Well, that's too thick as well. We've got a bit of white, haven't we? A bit of white ribbon. Got my ribbon box. I'll just do a little couple of stitches because, like I said, I'm going to go back in and add the all I'm doing here, so I can trim it up if it's a bit big. What I'm going to do here is a little slip stitch. In fact, I can cut that back a little bit because I've got quite a lot on there. Gosh, I keep knocking the camera, sorry. If he finds a bit, you can just trim that off a bit if you've got too much. So all I'm doing is a little slip stitch on the side. Just go around like that. So continue all the way around like that with a little slip stitch. Overstitch, is it? Overstitch. Slip stitch, overstitch. That just makes it nice and secure. It goes around like that. You can see I can trim that bit off, and then the ribbon, what I do with the ribbon, I just tuck that in, and again, just stitch that stitch over it. I'll just show you here on these ones, so it's stitched right in there. A bit of lace on that one. So, there we go. So that's how I make my little stitched hearts. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Apologise for coming out of camera shot, and I've knocked the camera a few times, so I do apologise. But I hope you've managed to enjoy the video, and if you have enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. And any comments, please leave them in the box below. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye now.